This week's Technique Tuesday video is the second in a series of videos on hat crown decreases. In this video, I'll be demonstrating a fitted hat crown with subtle decreases. This hat crown is suitable for many types of hats. I'll explain how the hat crown decreases are worked, and I'll give you a cheat sheet to make planning for this type of hat crown really easy. So let's get started. The crown is worked in the top one-third of the total length of the hat. When I say the total length, I mean from here on up. This has extended ribbing that gets folded back. So the total length of the hat as it's worn would be this, and the crown would be in the top third of that. The crown itself is worked in stockinette stitch. So it works really well when the hat itself is in stockinette, but you could work a stitch pattern in the body and then switch to the hat crown, but you would not be able to maintain the stitch pattern as you are working the crown of the hat. It could also work really well for a hat where the band or the entire body is worked sideways, like this one was. This was a hat band that was worked in garter stitch as a strip that was then joined into a loop. And then stitches were picked up around the top of that loop in order to work the crown. So this particular hat, the pattern calls for working these spiraling defined decrease lines, but you wouldn't have to do that if you didn't want a hat crown that had that sort of decorative appearance. If you wanted something that was a little more subtle than that, then you could use this type of a hat crown instead. So if you look at this little line drawing that represents the hat, this section right here depicts where the crown decreases will be worked. And so, as I mentioned, the crown is worked in about the top one-third of the hat. And so the ribbing and the main body of the hat take up about two-thirds of the hat. So in order to plan for this type of crown, you have to know how long you're going to make the hat and therefore how long the actual crown will be. Let's assume that we are going to knit a hat that is 8 inches in length, which is about 20 centimeters in total length. That means that the crown is going to be one-third of those. So 8 inches divided by 3 is equal to 2.67 inches. 20 centimeters divided by 3 is equal to 6.67 centimeters. So if this is how long the hat crown is going to be, this is how long the hat itself is going to be when we switch to working the hat crown. And likewise, if we are working in centimeters, the hat will be this long when we switch to working the hat crown. By the time you've knitted enough of the hat that you know that it's time to start the hat crown, you will have enough fabric down here that you can just measure how many rows are going to be in the hat crown length that you need. So I'm going to lay my ruler next to a column of stitches and I'm going to count the number of rows. So I'm looking at this V here at the top and it's in line with this here. So I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So 13 is just over 2.5. 14 would get me to 2¾ inches. So let's say we're going to do 13 rounds. So this is a little cheat sheet that I've created, and I will leave a link down below if this is something that you want to use to help you plan your hat crowns. So we looked and we saw that we were going to need 13 total number of rounds for our hat crown. This hat crown has 5 decrease rounds. That is true regardless of your stitch count, yarn weight, whatever. There will be 5 decrease rounds. So that means that of the 13 total rounds, 8 of them are going to be plain rounds that we have to distribute throughout the crown after the decrease rounds. And the way that this particular crown is worked is that the majority of those plain rounds are worked early on in the crown and very few of them are worked later in the crown. So you work fewer and fewer plain rounds as you work the crown. So the general rule is that about half of the total number of plain rounds you need are going to be worked after the first decrease round. We have an even number that's very easy to divide in half into four. And then after the second decrease round, we are going to work about a quarter of them. So that would be two. So that is six out of the eight altogether. We've only got two left. So we want to be working fewer and fewer rounds altogether, with the fewest at the very end. We only have two plain rounds to distribute, so we can do one plain round after each of those decrease rounds. And that will give us our plan for how we are going to work our crown decreases. So the first decrease round, again, it's worked the same way regardless of how many stitches you have, what yarn weight you are working. You are going to knit two stitches and then knit two together. And you're going to repeat that for the entire round. Knit two stitches, knit two together, all the way around. Again, you're not maintaining a stitch pattern at this point other than stockinette. You have stopped working any stitch pattern that you might have been working for the body of your hat. So if you are getting to the end of the round and you see you don't have enough stitches to do knit two together, that's fine. Just knit whatever stitches are remaining in this decrease round. So I finished my first round and now I need to knit my plain round. So for my hat, I'm going to be knitting four plain rounds. So if you have worked a few plain rounds and you're not sure whether or not it's time to work another decrease round, you can count rows on your knitting. So let's take a look at how you tell where the decrease is and then how many plain rounds you have worked. So if you look at these two, this column of V's right here, the stitches, and this column right here, you can see they come together and now there's one column above them. So this right here, where these two come together, that is the decrease round. Anything that is above this decrease but below the needle tells you how many plain rounds you've worked. So I can see I've got one V here, two V's here, and a third one here. I don't count the one that's on the needle. So I need to work four plain rounds, but now I can see that I've only worked three. So I need to work one more plain round before I can work my next decrease round. So in this decrease round, we knit one stitch and then knit two together, and then we repeat that for the entire round. And again, when you approach the end of the round, if you do not have enough stitches to work a complete repeat of knit one, knit two together, don't worry about it. Just work however many stitches are remaining in the round. Just work them as plain knit stitches. I've completed the second decrease round and now I need to knit two plain rounds. So I can tell that this is my decrease, that I've got those two stitches joined together and that I have worked two rounds after that decrease round. So now it's time for my third decrease round. So now we can see that decrease round three is also worked as knit one, knit two together, and we repeat that for the entire round. And then once we've completed that, we're going to knit one plain round. Once again, we can confirm that I've got my decrease round here and I have one plain round after it. So now it's time to work decrease round number four. Again, it is worked the same way that decrease round two and three were worked, with a knit one, knit two together. And then this one is also followed with one plain round. I have worked the first four decrease rounds and all of the plain rounds that come after them. So the final decrease round is just to knit two together and repeat that for the entire round. And I do have a little note here about doing a knit two together a couple more times if necessary. And so I'll talk about that once I get to the end of my round. The idea for this final decrease round is to get down to a small enough number of stitches that when you fasten off the live stitches, the top will close up very tightly. So typically what you want is a number of stitches that will fit into about an inch to an inch and a half of given whatever yarn weight you're working with. So I'm working with a worsted weight yarn at about five stitches per inch. So I want to get down to say 6 to 8 stitches altogether by the time I'm done with my round. So I currently have 9 stitches on the needle. I could just work another knit 2 together if I wanted to get myself down to 8 stitches. And then that for sure would create a tight enough hole at the end. If you have too many stitches, the center just ends up being a little bit bigger. You just can't crowd that many stitches together. So I wanted to do one more example of how to calculate plain rounds, just to show you something, a variation on that. So let's say this time we want a hat that is 9 inches in length total. That would mean that the crown would be 3 inches in length. And so let's say that we measure 3 inches of fabric on our hat and we see that that is equal to 20 rounds. So we come to our cheat sheet and then we figure out how we're going to distribute all of our plain rounds. So we've got 20 total rounds and we have 5 decrease rounds. That means we have to distribute 15 plain rounds. So again, after that first decrease round, we want to have about half of our total plain rounds. Well, this is an odd number, so we could either do 7 or we could do 8. It really doesn't matter which way you go, just choose one of them or the other. So let's say we're going to choose 8 rounds here. And then we need about a quarter, and that's going to be about 4 rounds. So now we've used up 12 of the 15 rounds. We've only got 3 rounds left, so we could do 2 plain rounds here, and we could do 1 plain round there. So that's one way that you could do something like that. The main thing is that you have about half here, and that you're reducing the number of plain rounds after each of the decreased rounds. The next video in this series will cover various ways to create spiral crown decreases, including how to use these types of decreases while maintaining the stitch pattern. Each hat crown video in this series will be added to my hat playlist as they are published. That playlist also includes videos on how to measure a head for a knitted hat and how to knit a hat without a pattern. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.